This is the coolest thought I've done in a while. That's from Oswald Chambers. And it's just so encouraging. If you're out there and you're in some kind of struggle or battle or tribulation, listen to what he says right here. He says, God does not keep his child immune from trouble. He promises, I will be with him in trouble. That comes from Psalm 91:15. Then Romans 8:35 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? And of course, we know no one or nothing can separate us. So it goes on to say, Oswald says, I feel sorry for the Christian who doesn't have something in the circumstances of his life that he wishes was not there. Shall tribulation, which comes from Romans 8:35, shall tribulation separate us? No. Well, it says, Oswald goes on to say, tribulation is never a grand, highly welcomed event, but whatever it may be, whether exhausting, irritating, or simply causing some weakness, it is not able to separate us from the love of Christ. Never allow tribulations or the cares of this world to separate you from remembering that God loves you. Matthew 13:22. Shall distress, can God's love continue to hold fast even when everyone and everything around us seems to be saying that his love is a lie and that there shall be no thing such as justice? Shall famine, can we not only believe in the love of God but also be more than conquerors even when we're being starved? Either Jesus Christ is a deceiver, having deceived even Paul, or else some extraordinary thing happens to someone who holds on to the love of God when all the odds are totally against him. Wow. Isn't that cool? Those miracles are still possible in the middle of our trials. And actually, I just want to say today that if you've been praying for miracles, if you've been praying to see God do signs and wonders or do great things, you know, in your life, in your day, in your family or whatever, do realize you're actually inadvertently praying for trial, because there's no need for miracles, signs or wonders or any kind of God breakthrough unless there is a trial or tribulation you face. There was no reason to cross the Red Sea without Pharaoh's army behind the Israelites, destined to kill them, and their back against the sea so that God would have to part it and they could go through on dry ground. You need to understand that it's in those moments that you are in the perfect place to see God do something amazing. Cling to the love of God and watch your God, who is amazing, who is love, show up.